Hello, this video is going to give you an overview of the IronCAD user interface. As you start up IronCAD, the first thing you'll see is the welcome dialog here. And the welcome dialog gives you some options here to create a 3D scene, a 2D drawing, or a 2D drawing draft in draft mode, the cause of draft mode. Also, you can click here to open an existing document, whether it be a drawing or a 3D scene. Down here, you can double click a line item here for existing files or recent documents that you have. And then you have some resources here, getting started, the community, contact support, things like that. And then you have some options about how you want the welcome dialog to show. So I'm going to go ahead and just click on 3D scene here. And then it pops me up with the new scene dialog. And I can pick some options. I've got English, metric. I'm going to pick a metric here, and you can pick one of the colors you want, or you can create your own template and put it in the template folder. Template folder shown down here. So I'm just going to click OK there to bring up a new template. And that's going to bring me into the main IronCAD UI. And some different components of the UI here. We have the quick access bar here. This can be customized. If you click the down arrow and click more commands, you can add to that if you want. The ribbon bar here has most of the commands you'll use. The feature tab will have extrude, spin, blend, fillet, chamfer, things like that. Sketch is for all your sketching, 2D sketching and constraints. The surface is for 3D curves and surfacing tools. Assembly is for all the different assembly manipulations and things like that. Some special sheet metal tools here on this tab. The welding tab is for the structural steel frame and cosmetic welding. Tools kind of has a clearance house of all the special tools in IronCAD, from constraints to mechanism mode to, you know, combine shapes, regenerate, things like that. Smart markup is a relatively new item for design review and markup of your models. Visualization is for rendering and animation, so you have all your options there. Annotation is for smart dimensions, PMI, 3D text, different notations there. And then Common has just a bunch of tools, settings and tools that are a lot of options. And then finally your add-ons, for any add-ons you have installed or some default add-ons that ship with IronCAD. So that kind of rounds out the ribbon bar. Another thing that makes IronCAD unique is the catalog browser over here on the right. And this has some default shapes that we ship with. You can see down there, there's an advanced shape catalog. There's a tools catalog that has some special tools. And then there's this menu here, and this kind of goes off the screen here, but this menu, if you click on this menu, it'll give you an access to other catalogs. But I can also redock this catalog down here at the bottom, and you can see all my different tabs here. I've got animation, I got materials, tools, I got all sheet metal parts, I've got some IronCAD mechanical catalogs. There's some special catalogs we ship with, steel frames, tank, just some examples, some rendering bump maps, things like that. But the shapes catalog is where you spend most of your time, and you can start a design from there. And then if you want to create your own catalog, you can come up to the Common tab and just click New, and you see it says Catalog 1. So just creates a blank catalog that you can drag and drop things into. And then you can save that anywhere you want. But just getting started with the catalog, you can left-click and drag a shape out into the scene. So I left-click and drag the block. And you see it puts a block in there in the center of the screen at 000. And then you see over on the left is our scene browser. And this is kind of our history tree here. I've got part one. I can expand that. And then I got the block feature. I can select that. And then expand that, and I've got my cross-section that's down there at the bottom level. And then another part of our user interface is kind of the selection mode that you can be in, where you can select once and you're in the part level, select again and you're at the shape level, and then select again and you're at the face or edge level. So you can keep toggling through those. When I'm at the shape level, I can right-click here and I can click Edit Cross-Section, and I can get to the 2D cross-section that kind of defines that shape. So and I can finish shape and edit it that way. Or I can undo there. The other way you can edit parts is by the handle. So if you select again into this feature mode, or what we call IntelliShape mode, I have all these red handles, and I can just pull these arbitrarily, or I can hold the control key down and resize symmetrically, and then I can type in a value, and you'll see I get an exact value there, and it gives me an idea of what my dimension is. I can drag this down, again, put in a value. So you can precisely or arbitrarily size your parts. I can continue on and add more shapes from the catalog with a smart snap of another feature. I'm going to drag a cylinder out. And you can see as I drag the cylinder, I get points at the end point and midpoints here, center of a face. I'm just going to drag and drop this cylinder on there. And you can see that you get the snap right at the center. So that helps you precisely position your shapes relative to one another. I can drag and drop an H cylinder out for a hole, give that a diameter, then maybe drag that down through the bottom of my part. And you see I get my part there. Again, I can continue on with the design just to give you a few more examples. I could turn on the tri-ball positioning tool, move that in. I could put that at the center, make a mirrored link copy it to the other side. I can select some edges here, grab these edges, right-click and create a blend there. We put that at 10 millimeters. So you just kind of see how all the tools are right on your model, which really helps make modeling easy. So that takes care of a lot of the basics of the 3D modeling. The next area I want to show is the 2D drawing. If I come up here and I click on the New button in the Quick Access Toolbar area, click New, I get some options here. I'm going to pick Drawing, click OK, and it brings up the New Drawing dialog. And maybe I'll take an ISO A2 size and just click OK, and it loads up that template for me, and I'm ready to make a drawing. One thing that I neglected to do back in the scene before I can make a drawing is I do have to save. So I'll go ahead and save my file. It does require you to save the file before you can make a view. So I come back into the drawing. I've got some different ribbon bars here. I've got my views for all the different view types. I've got annotations for all my dimensions and symbols, tables, things like that. Sketch for any supplementary geometry I want to put on my drawing. Some common tools, units, sheet setup, things like that. And then some extra add-ons if you have add-ons in your drawing. So I'm going to click Standard here for my views. And I want to pick a front view, left view, bottom, top, and just go ahead and place my views. And the views are associative back to the model, of course. So I can zoom down in here. I can come over to annotation, and I can use this single smart dimension tool to create all kinds of different dimensions. A diameter, I can put a diameter here. I can put a radius dimension out here. I can grab two edges. Oop. Let me try an edge. Another edge. I can put one edge, or I can grab two edges, and then go edge to edge, and just kind of dimension the drawing the way I'd like. And then I can come back into the model, and I can update the model. So I give a few different dimensions here and there, change the diameter here, and if I come back into the drawing, it prompts me. It says the views need to be updated, and it puts a border around the view, and I just hit OK, and you can see the dimensions update, and I get the actual values there. So that's just kind of an overview of the IronCAD user interface. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thank you very much.